Welcome to Dating, Marriage, and Life Stories with Kansiime Grace. To all the returning viewers, you're welcome. Thank you so much. Kindly remember to like and to drop a comment, and I do not take you for granted. To all the new viewers, you're so welcome. Please remember to sign in your Google account, subscribe, and like, and drop a comment. I am so grateful. Please watch to the end as we talk about dating, my own experience of dating, and then we'll talk about purposeful dating, and then we'll talk about how long should you date, and then we'll also talk about honesty. How much honest should you be? Well, personally, I have been married for 30 years, and my children are now adults, and one of them is already married. And by the grace of God, we are still going strong. I dated for 2 weeks. We met my husband through mutual friends. He saw me. He was looking for a wife, and these people called me on my birthday. I had no idea. We met, and we ate food. After eating food, he just greeted me and walked away. And then 2 weeks later, he comes and tells me, oh, I've been thinking about you for the 2 weeks, and I think I want to marry you. Just like that. And I was like, but you're not my type, you know? He wasn't dressed like I was. He doesn't even know how to talk. He doesn't even have an engagement ring. He just doesn't have anything. He just isn't my type. And I'm like, oh my God. Okay, but when I did my search, this man is so honest. He's so good. He's just so every girl's dream, except me, who was looking for good chat. He was looking for someone who knows how to pull the chair. And you know those fantasies that all girls go with. I put down my pride. I knew that God wants me to marry a man who loves me. Girls, if you get a man who loves you, whether he's rich or whether he doesn't dress the way you want, but as long as he's working, he's able to take care of you, take care of your basic minimum, and you also work. Don't look up to the man alone. That is the guy to go to. The man must love you like crazy. The Bible says, and a man shall love his wife. There's nowhere in the Bible where they talk about a woman loving the man. They talk about submission. So the condition for dating this guy with the hope of marriage is that the guy must love you 100%. And that is the purpose number one of dating. And then number two, purpose of dating, this girl must respect you. Guys, don't ever go with a girl who doesn't have any respect for you, a girl who doesn't respect your parents, a girl who shames you before your friends, a girl who doesn't respect herself. That is a wastage of your time. The purpose of dating is to meet this person who loves you, who respects you, accept each other's weaknesses, and whatever you cannot work around, if you can stand it, don't wait for this person to change. If you can stand it at that moment, go with that guy, go with that girl. Some things will change because this person loves you a great deal. How long should we date? I have seen people dating, I call it witchcraft. I've seen people dating someone's daughter or committing this guy for 5 years, 10 years. You know what are you looking for in 10 years? They give you an engagement ring and there is no wedding date in view, inside. There's no wedding date, there's no commitment. Even if it is 5 years, tell her, I'm giving you this ring, in 5 years we'll get married, and stick to it. And so how long someone should date is when you know why you are dating. There are people who date for fun. And when you date for fun, make this girl know, let this guy know that you're dating for fun. There is no prospect of marriage, so that they don't look at it. I've seen guys waste girls' time, and no girls grow. And when they grow older, nobody is more interested. Yet for men, when they are growing older, someone new wants them. So stop engaging girls when you don't see the future of marriage in the picture. Date purposefully that there is marriage. And how long should you date? that will be as per your agreement. Agree this is for fun. You can date for as long as each one of you gets another spouse and they go. Agree you're dating for marriage. Put a time frame to it when resources are available and have each other under the same roof. And that is going to be the best thing. And remember, during this dating, you accept each other's burden and don't work at changing them. Someone will change as long as they're falling in love with you. How honest should couples be while dating? Now, I've seen some people, you meet this guy and then guys don't talk so much, but he's going to talk about all his friends. He's going to talk about how his stepmother is wicked. He's going to talk about how his clan is not so good. And he's going to even lie how his father is very rich. You know, guys will have those things that are not so honest. He will even lie. He can afford to borrow a car time and again to come and see you. That is not honesty. The day you lie to this girl, when she discovers the real you, she's going to dump you and she will hate you. And if she doesn't dump you and hate you, she's going to get another guy and add him to you. That is how bad it can be. And let me tell you, girls, you have a child. You don't want to talk about that child. You keep lying, those are your sister's children. You come from a bad background. You keep lying that is not your family. You go to your auntie's place and you lie that is your auntie. Let me tell you, when I was dating my husband, I told him, I said, look, you think that I'm a good girl? I'm big-headed. I argue. I don't do something that I don't want to do. Number three, see, they had me while they were in school, my mother and my father, and they have since gotten married. And so I'm there in the middle, I'm not anywhere. Am I good enough for you? My husband said, yes, you're good enough. Even with your big head, he still tells me now. When I argue, I try to argue, he's like, yeah, you told me you have a big head, so I choose to accept it. And he says, even with your big head, even with your, you know, rejection and bad background, I still take you. And guess what? He thinks I'm the best thing that ever happened to him 30 years down the road. And I thought that he loved me when we met. I thought he loved me so much. But over the years, this guy loves me more and more each year that passes by. And I can confidently say that I am blessed. I am so blessed because I was even very honest in the beginning. I told him everything that he needed to know about me. Did I go ahead to tell him how there are some bad people in my clan? No, I didn't tell him. I didn't tell him who is a witch in my background, because the more you talk, the more this person places you in a certain class. The witches are there, but they are not you. So you don't even have to bother talking about them. Don't talk about a stepmother who raised you and brought you up to where you are. And I can confidently say, bring out the things that may later be discovered about you. About you, not about your father, not about your relatives, not about your clan. Talk about you. If you have HIV, talk about it. If you urinate on the bed, talk about it. I would rather the person accepts me with all my flaws, or he goes away if he can't accept them. There will always be that one special person that will accept you. You urinate on the bed, yes. You are poor, yes. A guy, you don't have any person in your background that you can look up to. This guy will accept you for who you are. In the marriage relationship, in the dating, talk about yourselves. The things that can cause problems when you're later married, talk about them. That this person should accept you or refuse you straight away. If you lie about them and they discover them in the future, then the marriage will go. So I would rather they take me now or they drop me. Talk about the things. This person takes you or he leaves you. Somebody else will definitely come and take you for who you are. That's about dating. Dating affects the early years of the marriage. 1, 2, 3 years, maybe 1 year or 5 months down the road. The reason why couples separate within the first the first months of their marriage is that the things they hid from each other while dating, even if you dated for 10 years, the things you hid from each other while dating, when you start living with each other and they come out, the children show up, the car that you lied was yours is not anywhere to be seen. The house you rented and you lied it was yours and is it cannot be seen. The family background you lied about that you are from a rich background and is not anywhere to be seen. Let me tell you, that is where the friction comes from in the first months, the first year of the marriage. So save yourself pain, save yourself separation, save yourself all the challenges in the first year of marriage by telling each other the truth. Talk about yourselves only. Don't talk about other people. Don't talk about other people. I know someone who used to say that guys normally go and even get dates to marry this girl. And you know, they lie, they get dates, they want to buy this girl a car, they want to do everything. And when they are married, they within the first year, they discover the girl is the wrong one. And how painful it could be for you. You are still paying the debt, the girl has gone. Or you, girl, you even borrowed money to get married to this guy, and then the marriage is no more and you're still paying the debt. It can be so painful. So take the person you accept and leave the person if you don't accept. There is never going to be a change. And if this person is going to change, they will change because they love you. They will change their dressing because they love you. They will change their eating habits, their talking habits because they love you. They will change the way they react to everything because they love you. And kindly subscribe. Please remember to like and watch this video time and time again when you need a reference. I look forward to seeing you again. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. God bless you.